So, Ben, this is your home, clubhouse, home away from home?
It was my parents' home. This is the rear cottage behind Preservation Hall. And this was actually where my parents first lived when they came to New Orleans.
And they came and they started Preservation Hall, essentially.
Yeah, they were instrumental in establishing Preservation Hall as we know it today. It was originally when they first came to town, when they first entered this building, this was an art gallery.
Okay.
And it was where a group of music enthusiasts and historians and artists and just insiders and outsiders were gathering in sort of a salon fashion.
Right.
And they were hosting these informal jam sessions. And this was the only place really in New Orleans that was taking place, because it was a...
Jazz had kind of died off in popularity, right?
The music had died off in popularity, but also we were, in the middle of the civil rights movement, and this was the segregated South, and African Americans and whites weren't allowed to openly, socialize the way that, that we kind of take for granted today.
Right.
And Preservation Hall, bucked that, and said, this music is worthy of being respected and honored in this fashion. And then, that was really the premise for it, was to give these aging African-American musicians a
place to play, right? Because a lot of them had been sort of, gone back to regular jobs and things like that.
Some had stopped playing. It is a career. And when the work dries up, you look to other means for survival.
Right. And what was it like, growing up, I know a little bit about this, but growing up in the tradition of music in your family, was it always just I'm going to play music?
It wasn't, I don't think it's one of those things that was, we never really talked about it in our family, and I don't think people in New Orleans really talk about it. It's something that you're a part of, you're part of a community of musicians, and it's not that you're expected to play, you do play.
Right.
It's just, you're surrounded by instruments, you're surrounded by musicians, and it's just something that your community supports and embraces,
Which is and encourages. So unique to this community.
Yeah, it is. It really is.
And what's different? It's so amazing. Jazz Fest is like a different time of year, clearly. It's a huge celebration. Is it a different vibe here at Preservation Hall, you feel, at Jazz Fest?
Yeah, there's definitely an energy in the air. People who are here during Jazz Fest are huge New Orleans enthusiasts. They're huge music enthusiasts. They're passionate about food. They're passionate about life, So, yeah, you do feel a sort of surge during Jazz Fest.
And what's some of your favorite? Clearly you're playing three shows a night here and running around all over town, but is there something that you get to do during Jazz Fest that you save just for you?
You
don't have to tell everybody, but...
What's special about Jazz Fest to me, I've been going since I was a little boy.
Me too.
Yeah, so...
not a little boy, a little girl.
But, when you participate in something that your father and your mother and your family, were a part of, then it's personal,
Right.
And then to be responsible and for helping to create the event, it's amazing, the shift. It's almost coming of age and something.
Yeah, when it's you're finally not just participating. Yeah, you're not watching it, you're participating.
Exactly,
in it.
Yeah. And for me it's also, I feel like, I'm getting older.
We're all getting older.
I know. I used to get it more often. What's a young kid like you doing in a place like this? I don't get it much anymore.
No, now you're in charge, right?
Yeah.
Is there something you're going to see this weekend that you're super stoked, or are you working the whole
time? Oh my gosh, I'm really excited to see Chaka Khan.
Me too. Can we meet and hang out at that place?
Totally. I'm a huge fan. Have been, since Rufus and MTV and
it's gonna be awesome. Yeah. There's always those things you have to choose, right? You're like, oh, but Chaka Khan is the one I'm gonna do for
totally.
Sure.
I love going out to Jazz Fest without an agenda. I love going out there and wandering around and kind of feeling where things are headed, and you hear something and you wander there and you hear it, and kind of have a vague idea of where you need to be.
Yeah, at certain times. I want to see all the Brazilian stuff this weekend too.
Yeah, there's incredible Brazilian music out there.
And you guys, I was at Coachella, and I saw you guys with Arcade Fire,
which
was super cool. Do you think, I mean, that might happen again?
You know, that was so
was it impromptu?
Spur of the moment. You know, we were backstage, and they were there, and we knew some of the musicians through mutual friends, and had met them before. So, you know, it was, hey, why don't you guys just come on out with us? And we're like, okay, you know.
Cool.
And it happened. So those kinds of things happen, you know, when you're, you know.
When you're in the moment. I mean, that's the thing. And I know another big thing is the poster this year.
Yes.
Which is huge. I mean, that's got to be a really big honor for you guys, right?
It's incredible. You know, it's, you never think you're going to be on the Jazz Fest poster. I mean, that's, you know, that's for Irma Thomas, and that's for Louis Armstrong. And
Aaron
for,
Neville.
Yeah, and Fats Domino. And, you know, it's not for us, you know, we're the kids, and it is amazing. It's an honor, and you know, not just for me, but I feel so privileged to be on the poster with people like Charlie Gabriel and Mark Bro, whose family's been playing music in New Orleans for four generations. You know, this is a way to honor not just ourselves, but our whole, you know, our family and our extended family and all the people who came. Who came before us.
Right. And I know you have your big, this weekend is also like a big benefit for you guys, right? You have the Midnight Preserve, and I'm sure it's sold out at this point. But can people try their luck if they want to come by this weekend and see?
I'm always a gambler. You know, I always expect that, you know, at least one or two people aren't going to show up. So, you know, I always try my luck.
And you might be able to get it.
You might
right?
be able, yeah. I mean, what's great about this year is every night features the Preservation Hall Band with some of our friends from different musical backgrounds. This past weekend, we had Bombino come and play with us, and we just saw them at Coachella as well. We had the infamous String Dusters, and yeah, it was amazing. It was an amazing week. Kemo came by.
Cool. He came by?
Flavor Flav was here. Our opening night, and
did he get up?
Ball. He went in and played the drums.
Amazing!
And in the audience, it was amazing. Everybody was just sort of wondering, you know, it was that kind of moment where it was, is this really happening?
Like, is Flavor Flav really playing the drums at Preservation Hall?
Yeah, is this really happening? Yes, it happened. Yeah.
Super
but
cool.
But that's what's amazing about this time of year is, you never know what's going to happen in town. You know, so much amazing music is happening, and so many, you know, people from just, you know, all kinds of musical backgrounds are here.
That's the amazing thing about this festival, I think, that's different than so many others, is you get every age, every background, every type of music lover, and they're all here just to enjoy.
I was thinking about that the other day. I was out there, and I was thinking how beautiful it was, because it really is like events in New Orleans, where you see grandchildren and grandparents attending the same thing together. You know, Mardi Gras. Everybody comes out for Mardi Gras. Everybody's having a good time.
Yeah.
You know, Jazz Fest.
You know? Well, there's not many music festivals you can go to, I think, where you can see little kids running around and then see, like, an 85-year-old man. Literally, I've seen, like, guys with, like, walkers out there that I'm like, damn, go for it, dude.
Yes,
like,
exactly.
Super cool.
Yeah, it's a beautiful thing. It is really, really special. Something that we really wear as a badge of honor.
Cool. Well, thank you so much for inviting me. I know you had so many shows tonight, and it's
so
much to do.
It's great
but
to
I'm so privileged, and hopefully let's go dance at Chaka Khan. Can we do that?
Absolutely.
Awesome.
You know, yeah.